education, academics, scholarships. That's the big one. When you think of those words, you must think of the Hellenic University Club of Philadelphia. Here tonight in Philadelphia, they're celebrating their 80th jubilee.
80th anniversary.
And we're with?
Katerina Dimitriadis.
Since she jumped in, I'm going to let her take it. Go ahead. Tell us about this evening.
Teddy, thank you. I am privileged and honored to be serving as president of the Hellenic University Club of Philadelphia this year. The organization started 80 years ago in 1936 from just 14 professionals who wanted to share our culture, our heritage, and our love of learning. In 1936, it was 14, and now we're here into the next century, and we're celebrating. Our mission over the years has become to not only come together for Adelfotita, like we did today, enjoy meeting, getting together with old friends and making new ones, but also we have an initiative this year to raise our scholarship fund to $1 million so that we can continue what our founders started 80 years ago and be able to award scholarships to many, many students, many scholarships every year for years to come. This was a lovely event, and I thank everyone, our sponsors, our board, and everyone who's here today to support us. Thank you.
Let me just ask you before you go.
Yes.
Tonight, one of the highlights was these three individual awards. How are you feeling about seeing these representatives of our community come up there and get these awards?
I am thrilled because Evangelos and Zenos Froudakis have been in the Philadelphia. They're renowned, world-renowned sculptors in the Philadelphia area. Their work and their creations are not only here locally, but they have enriched lives local and worldwide. And then, of course, Dr. Asani's, what a wonderful man, and I think the University of Delaware is lucky to have him. So we are thrilled to be honoring, and it is our privilege to be honoring them tonight.
We're with Dr. Dennis Asani's, University of Delaware, who received the Bedia Award this evening. Dr. Asani's, welcome to Cosmos Philly.
Thank you so much.
Tell us about the award this evening. How important was this award for you? You've been recognized for many other awards, but this one might hit home for you now in your new home. Here, maybe not in Philadelphia, but nearby.
I feel so privileged and honored to be receiving the Pedia Award from my friends in the Hellenic University Club of Philadelphia for so many reasons. First of all, because it integrates my wife Eleni and myself and my family with all the Greek American families in the area, and so symbolically that means a lot to us. But more importantly, as an individual, I've dedicated my entire life to the relentless pursuit of academic excellence. I've been in some of the best academic institutions in the world, MIT, the University of Illinois, Michigan, Stony Brook, and now the University of Delaware as its president. I'm really honored and privileged to dedicate myself to giving Pedia to others because education is our ticket to a better society.
You also mentioned the weakest and the strongest links in a society. Could you briefly talk about that from your speech?
Yes, absolutely. I truly believe that, they say if you want to go fast, you can go alone. But if you want to go far, you've got to go together. So a society that educates all its citizens, the strong and the weak links, will no longer have weak links. So together we can do marvelous things. That's what a true society is all about.
We're with acclaimed sculptor Evangelos Froudakis of Philadelphia, who was one of the honorees this evening. Evangelos, welcome to Cosmos Philly. How are you feeling about this evening's event?
It was a wonderful experience to see so many friendly Greeks, people I've never known, and feel that I know now. There's warmth, they come up, meet you, and share with you. It's been a wonderful evening.
During your speech, you mentioned as an artist, you have to find your own path, not to copy other people's work. Could you elaborate a little bit on that?
I feel, as a sculptor, seeking a road of fulfillment in my talent, which was sculpture. But those who come and share with you their knowledge help you along the road of understanding, but they're not your road. You have to find that which gives you completeness. And men I mentioned, like Paul Manship and Joe Davidson, they were truly artists that reached their identity and made a great contribution to Western art. I, too, not only seek that road and have sought it and feel that it fulfilled it somewhat, but in teaching, I don't want anything when I have a student to have something blocking them from going all the way by saying, I'm the truth. They have to find their own truth through their own experience, through their own, let's say, imagination. The nearest word I can think of at the moment. You have to become the poet and go where no one else has ever gone to make that unique contribution. That's where I hope that I've been to and will continue to go.
Well, tonight we have another sculptor with us, Zenos Fludakis. It's a special evening for you, an award from your community, from your own cultural community. How does it feel receiving this award from the Hellenic University Club?
Well, I'm deeply honored, and I'm especially pleased to be getting an award while my brother gets an award as well. It's a wonderful evening for me, and I love being around, you know, other Greeks, and you know, this is my heritage, and both in terms of my culture and the sculpture that I do. This is very much rooted in Greek aesthetics.
Well, let's talk a little bit about your work. Where are you at with it today?
Well, I'm working on a sculpture right now of an attorney who was in a Scopes trial. It's a 7-foot sculpture, and it's going to go at the courthouse where the Scopes trial took place. It's of Clarence Darrow. I'm working on a sculpture of a CEO of State Farm Insurance. You know, I've done a lot of pieces, over 100 bronze figures. They're in Greece, they're in Japan, they're in England.
Is there a favorite type of work you like?
My freedom sculpture is my favorite, and that kind of work is my favorite. I mean, I don't like to think of one kind, but I like the idea of doing something that it's about an idea, it's about freedom. I want to do another piece next about time. I like doing big ideas if I can. I love philosophy, which I get from the Greeks, of course, and poetry, which I also get from the Greeks. But so I try to put that into my work.